Are we zooming? Just going around the entrance again. I don't travel far.
What about for your holidays?
Well, I am going up to Byron again very shortly. That should be interesting.
Wow.
So there's a party. Someone's turning 60 and there's a band playing, and that's going to be fun. And the Zoom will be there, plus the drone. That's going to be nice going over...
I'm not going.
The rivers. Aren't you coming?
No, I've got something else on that weekend, I think.
Alrighty.
Okay.
Well, here we come to another show.
Well, yes, it's that time of the week.
It is.
G'day, good afternoon, good evening, maybe good morning or good whatever it is, wherever you're listening in to us across this big musical world on the Jonesy
World
Wide Web.
Hang on, World Wide Web, and it's summer.
It is summer.
It's summer in the city. Let me...
That is one of my favorite songs. Hot in the city, hot in the city tonight.
You're talking about the birthday boy, Billy Idol.
Is that?
Billy Idol turned 65 this week.
Wow, I'm just...
Didn't you know that?
I don't know much at all, but I do know I like that song. That's one of my favorite driving songs.
He turned 65.
But isn't country.
I tell you what, there's a social media post going around, especially I shared it as well, but on Australian Radio Indie on our social media pages. Mm-hmm. Here, Billy Idol turns 60, and there's a picture of him as like an 18-year-old, and a picture of him as a 65-year-old, and man, he's still fit.
Yeah, he would be. All that jumping around on stage.
Yeah, and whatever else he uses to stay slim, because he looks fabulous.
We're just jealous now.
Says the old bloke sitting here, yeah. But I was looking for something, but we'll go back to that other thing. What did you say?
The World Wide Web.
Streaming right across the World Wide Web.
Wow, I did that without...
Australian Radio Indie.
I did that without moving my lips.
There you go. That's another little jingle that I just discovered that I haven't used for a while.
Anyway, greetings and welcome to the Australian Radio Indie Music Scene Broadcast and Podcast with Dingo and Jonesy. This is episode 14.
14, so we've passed that curly number.
You keep bringing that number up, Jonesy.
I didn't
say
that.
If you've missed an episode, feel free to go back and watch older episodes. Just search Australian Radio Indie on YouTube as we broadcast this show for the first time on Sunday night.
What's your favourite lock playing for South Sydney? Who's your favourite lock? And what number does he wear on his back?
Oh, I don't know. Eric Sims. He was my favourite South Sydney player.
He was a fullback.
I know. Anyway, you always kid me.
Turn it on and turn it up. You're on Australian Radio Indie.
And you'll be listening...
And Dingo.
And you'll be listening to this program for the first time on Sunday night around 7 o'clock, right after the Australian Radio Indie Top 10.
Yeah, another great Top 10. And the Top 10 Song of the Week, you know which one was the number one?
Nope.
Mr. Bailey, Colin Bailey.
Colin Bailey.
Yeah, with Dance My Dance.
Oh.
You know, you probably haven't even heard that with your...
No, I do listen to your top 10.
Okay, yeah.
Because well, I don't want to miss the beginning of this program.
Yes, the way, because sometimes the top 10 only goes for about 40 minutes, depending on the length of the 10 songs that are in there and how much waffle I can do.
I would waffle and Jonesy. I wouldn't have believed that.
No, I'm king of the waffle. I should have started an ice cream shop.
I think so. Hey, speaking of ice cream,
yeah, there's a new song coming out.
Yeah, I know that in not this program, but another...
Next week's program?
Another program.
On the next
we
program.
May have a link there
okay,
to a bit of ice cream.
I'm a bit partial to the old ice cream truck.
Yes.
Well, the ice cream van, man.
Anyway, the radio show is also broadcast again on Australian Radio Indie at 8 p.m. on the Monday night. The YouTube episode will premiere online, but after that, you can watch or stream it anytime. Good evening to Nick in Croatia.
This is Steve, and I listen to Australian Radio Indie because they got all my favorite bands and they even play bands I didn't even know I like yet.
Thank you.
That was Steve from Pearl City, Illinois.
That was Steve. He liked something. I saw that he was very, very much like one of our recent programs. So also a big shout out to Helmut in Austria and
Helmut.
Yes. Right. And
what's that in English?
Helmut.
Is it
safety cap?
It's not like John or
I don't know.
Helmet.
Henry.
Could be Harry.
Harry. Anyway, Harry also a big shout out to Warren and Dave from the USA for their ongoing kind words. Glad you're enjoying the great music and the interviews. And speaking of interviews, we've got a cracker for you today. If you want a shout out, leave us a comment and your name and location in the YouTube comments, Radio Indie social media, or go to Australian Radio. Audio and click the contact us button and we'll be sure to mention you. Thanks for the fantastic positive feedback from last week's show where we interviewed Amelia from Nearly Rich.
Oh, nice. Yep. That was good.
Yes, it was.
Streaming right across the World Wide Web. Australian Radio Indie.
Who's doing that?
I don't know, but Jonesy,
sorry.
I know we normally discuss what we did during the week, but I went to one of Nearly Rich's album launches.
Nice.
And in Jonesy, it was, as you would say, sensational.
Sensational.
Anyway, you should drop on by the YouTube channel or spend some time listening to Matt and Amelia from Nearly Rich's albums online. Yeah. And don't forget, if you purchase their cracking album Love Bender online, you get some surprise acoustic extras.
Ooh.
Yep.
Acoustic. That'd be interesting.
Yes. They've recorded a couple of, because I guess they had big plans, which didn't, you know, it was meant to be released early on, and they released a couple of extra singles. They then had to give their online listeners some additional value for money. And so they went down to our good friend's studios with Jay Sini and recorded a couple of extra songs. So, obviously, CDs get printed and produced and all that sort of thing. Yep. So, yes, unfortunately, there's not a deluxe edition CD, but the electronic digital versions, you can listen to those acoustic songs.
So, when you were out at this gig, did you meet anyone that I should know about?
I bumped into someone who,
okay.
I guess Amelia mentioned my name because I had on a bright shirt.
Hang on. Who was that? Hang on.
Hey, guys. It's Matt and Amelia from Nearly Rich.
Yes.
And you're listening to our brand new single, My Town.
Oh, not yet. That was last week.
That was last week. So, anyway, Amelia mentioned me and then someone who was the partner of someone that we have had on, Glenn Bidmead, came over and introduced herself to me.
So, Lorraine.
Lorraine.
The lovely Lorraine.
Lovely Lorraine.
She's the backing singer for the new band. Thank you.
Is it the Ungrateful Brothers?
I was thinking of the Ungrateful Dead.
No, I think it's Glenn Bidmead and the Ungrateful Brothers. Mm-hmm. Anyway, if you've got a suggestion or observation, don't be shy. Leave us a comment. Speaking of comments, we're trying a new format for the next few weeks where we feature more music. And we were meant to be featuring less ramble, Jonesy. But either way,
just slap me, mate.
What have we got coming up? We've got a very, very busy program. We have a returning guest from a previous episode. But before of that, Jonesy.
Yes.
We've already covered what we're going to do. So
we have.
Well, you've been working. I attended Nearly Rich. So you know what? Enough chat. Let's stick with our less ramble. We've got a guest waiting for us soon. Before we introduce our very special returning guest, let's open the video vault to enjoy one of their songs. Summertime Soundtrack was released in November 2017 by Hayley Jensen. It's a very upbeat song about summer. Let's play the song and get Hayley on the phone. Then we can chat to her. Jonesy, keep an eye on the girl with the purple tint to her hair in the video. You may recognize her from one of our previous shows.
Ooh.
Jonesy, make it so.
Okay, let's get it on.
Driving back roads top down in a four-wheel drive. To unwind. broken up sunshine. Cold beer boombox, feeling alive. Kick it off with a kick drum, back it up with some bass tone. Round it off with that rhythm, gets me every time. Won't you give me a melody and a little harmony? It's my tune now, take me back, no doubt, summertime soundtrack. Love a red sky sunset, turning into moon. Taste of champagne, keep it flowing all night. Beach hair jukebox, Tiki burns bright.
Summer. Australian Radio Indie.
Yes, boss.
There you go. That's a great song, Jonesy. Let's get Haley on the line.
Yeah, let's with the. Well, I'll do that line with the magic of technology. Let's see if Haley's on the line. Usually he says
hey,
Haley.
You got me.
It works. Anyway, Haley, welcome to Australian Radio Indie. We're talking to Haley Jensen about her new release, Fireworks. Haley, Jonesy and I just opened up the video vault, and we were watching and sharing with our audience Summertime Soundtrack, your summer-themed hit song from 3 years ago.
Yeah.
It's an upbeat and catchy tune, and that was a great video. I love the song. It was one of my, well, it's one of my go-to summer songs. In fact, it was playing in my head the other day as an earworm, along with the cicadas that you can probably hear.
Oh, man.
And but we can cut. And I looked at the video for the first time because generally I'm just listening to music, and was very surprised to see our good friend Amy Nelson from Saskatchewan as one of your co-stars.
Absolutely, yeah. Amy happened to be in town. She was in town, you know, for a little while doing some shows and things in the lead up, and then. And, you know, it just so happened that I was doing my music video the next weekend, and Tara, now the sort of mutual business partner at the time, said, Amy, do you want to be in Haley's music video? And so she delayed her flight and stayed around for an extra week to be in the video with me, which was just awesome. And we love Amy. She's a gorgeous girl, very talented. And I spent a fair bit of time with Amy last year when I was over in Canada myself. So, you know, when she's out here, we help her around and take her around, and she did the beautiful honor for me, and took me around, and we did a whole bunch of shows together, and yeah, great spending a lot of time with her. She's a beautiful girl. And she's my best friend in the video and the Summertime soundtrack.
Well, that video from Click Productions looked like it was a lot of fun to make. What was the backstory of that song?
It was a lot of fun. This song I wrote when I was over in Nashville with a great writer over there, Alex Pierre. And, yeah, we just wanted to write a really fun party summer song. And I actually had the session book in and the night before woke up at, I don't know, what, some middle of the night, you know, in my Airbnb. And I just had the chorus of that song just was going round and round in my head. And I pulled out my little phone and, you know, the memo. I thought I'd better, you know, record this thing into my voice memos. Otherwise, I'm going to forget it tomorrow. And, yeah, had a listen tomorrow. Usually when you do that, but, you know, you never know what you're going to get. But this one, I thought, oh, I think we can work with that. So took it into the writing session and, yeah, rest is history. It was kind of, you know, very much one of my most successful songs, I guess, up until the recent one, Breaking Hearts. And, yeah, it's just, I think it's one of those songs that will just live on because it's just such a catchy tune and just great for the season that we're in right now, I guess.
Yeah, it is. It is. For those people who are just listening, make sure you check out the video, Summertime Soundtrack by Hayley Jensen on YouTube. But either way, you know what? Drop Jonesy a line and see if we can get Summertime Soundtrack some more airplay over these summer months.
That's a good vibe.
Yeah, they've only got to come to either social media and request it, or they've only got to come to www.australianradio.audio and follow the links to submit a request, and that's how they get into our top 10.
Okay, so
beautiful.
So for all of Hayley's fans,
all of Hayley's comments,
right? Let's fill Jones's inbox.
That's it. You wait for it.
That'd be great to see.
Anyway, Hayley, as COVID restrictions are lifting Australia wide, where are you sitting at the moment?
I am at my hairdresser.
Hang on.
I went the wrong one.
That's a first for us. I guess you've got lots and lots of gigs coming up, so you're probably going between the hairdresser and the gym at the moment, are you?
You've nailed it, actually. I'm, you know, eating my portion-sized meals in between the gym and the hairdresser. That's exactly right. I do have some shows coming up.
You know
and,
what?
Great to be back on the road. You know, got to fix the regrowth and all that. So.
Zingo's a bit of a aficionado on people's social media, so he checks everyone, what they're up to everywhere. You got to keep an eye out on the old Dingo.
No, well, that is with COVID at the moment. I've been talking to a bloke who walks past my front door, and he, you know, the theory is that after COVID, you're either going to come out either a hunk, a drunk,
yeah,
or a chunk.
I was going to say, or a monk.
Or a monk. Yeah, that may be the other one. Anyway.
I think I qualify for three of those.
Hayley, we spoke.
I don't know about the hunk, but.
We spoke to you in episode 3 of our podcast series, and since then you've had some absolutely fantastic success with your song Breaking Hearts. You've got to be very happy with the reception that song and video received.
Oh, it has been crazy, and thank you guys so much for featuring the song. It really did go crazy. And I'm so proud of it. You know, it was kind of a little bit of a new direction for me working with a new producer and new songwriters, producers over in Canada. Actually, Amy Nelson introduced me to this wonderful producer. So there you go. The Amy connection continues. But, it's just done so well for me both here in Australia and also in Canada because we released it to Canadian radio as well. And so on their country radio, it was in the top number 32 on the CBC SiriusXM charts, which goes all across North America. So it's it's a bit of a dream come true for me. This song.
What about talk? What are you allowed to talk numbers in Australia?
Talk numbers?
Yeah, did it do any? I think it probably did well in Australia. Oh, go on, boast a little bit.
It did. Yeah, all right. At one point, it was the number one Australian song at country radio here. It was the number two overall. I got picked to the post by good old Hardy and Lauren Elena, who stuck in there for a few weeks, I think. So, but you know, I think it came in at something like number 5 to the chart. So it was just sort of, you know, came in. And I've never had a song in the official music network charts before, and this song just kind of blew it all out of the water. So now I've got to live up, try to keep living up to it.
Peer group pressure, eh?
That's it.
I find when new listeners, especially with us, when new listeners hear the different music that you play, or a new song comes out and they hear it for the first time, and they just go back to your back catalogue as well, and they want to know who is this person, especially when you get someone from overseas, as the World Wide Web radio sort of works for us.
No, it is. It's incredible, isn't it? I mean, I certainly do that when I hear somebody that I've never heard before, this song on the radio. I go straight searching for who are they? What are they? Are they new? Have they put stuff out? You know, I love it. Love discovering new music that way.
Oh, but, and it's just so good sometimes when you hear a song and you discover someone, and then 3 or 4 months later, they will then put out an album and you go, I know this song already. It's just so good.
Yeah.
I seen a guy, a young bloke called Ty Penshorn, mm-hmm. playing up at MySex. He was the support act for MySex. And I thought, I'll go grab his album, you know, and at the end of the gig. And he said, oh, yeah, I like this one, and this one. And if you'd like to play one, try to play this one. So I had a listen. I went, oh, yeah, that's okay, you know. But I don't know what's wrong with my ear, but I like different songs that the artists definitely don't pick, unfortunately.
Singles.
Yeah, but
well, you know, sometimes people pick the songs as singles that they think are going to be the most, you know, appeal to the broad. But I know for myself, you know, you've got to pick which ones you're going to release as singles, and it's really hard because, you know, I look back at my previous albums too, and I think, oh, I should have released that one as a single, or I should have released that one, because it just becomes, you know, when people get the whole catalog, they start requesting all the ones that, you know, the B-sides or the ones that didn't become singles, and you think, oh, I wonder if I should have done that. But it's, you know, well, tricky choice.
Well, I went through his back catalogue and I found that he released one of the songs I really liked in his performance. That came out almost 7 years ago, and really cool film clip to it, and really cool. And I thought, geez, I'm going to start playing this. It's been out for 7 years, but I'll tell you what, a lot of people are going to hear it for the first time.
Good on you. That's great. I love that. Why should a song, you know, be discriminated against because it's been out for 7 years?
No, that's
it's a
right.
good song. Well, it's a bloody good song.
And when you hear it for the first time, it's brand spanking new.
Yeah.
That's it. Exactly right.
We're speaking to Hayley Jensen. As I said in episode 3 of our YouTube podcast, Hayley, as a result of her television appearances and recording successes and touring as a household name in Australia, I thought rather than recap all of your bio again, if our audiences want to know more about you, I'm going to suggest they go back and check out episode 3 where we chat about your background and play your chart-topping song Breaking Hearts and discuss that very special accompanying video, Jonesy, Executive Decision on the Run.
Yep. Here we go.
Breaking Hearts is a ripper. You and I love the video.
Yep.
Let's get it on again. Breaking Hearts, make it so.
Okay, here it is.
Shouldn't have made you with a warning sign. You shouldn't have all up.
audience definitely loves that song.
And wow, and it charted so well. It just charted so well.
We've got Sonic. We've got Sonic and Ashton sitting next to us. They're two acoustics. And that's our studio audience in the green room.
Oh, love it.
Two acoustic guitars.
I was going to say the choir of crickets are going wild for that song.
Cicadas.
Cicadas. If you haven't seen last week's podcast or the week before's, we've done a cicada special and Dingo was in the wild.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah.
Dingo's in the wild.
Haley, during that previous interview about Breaking Hearts in episode 3, you gave us a little hint of what was to come, and with COVID restrictions lifting, it looks like it's all going to plan as you're all going to be on the road again soon with gigs and you've got more music.
Yes, so that's exactly right. So, you know, you just had to keep working behind the scenes with everything because, you know, even though we can get out and perform live, people are still wanting to hear new songs and, you know, it's still a great opportunity. People listening to the radio, tuning in and listening to music in different ways. So just wanted to keep the momentum going. And I've got a bunch of new songs I'm really excited about. The latest one I've just released is called Fireworks. And it's just a really beautiful, fun song about being with the people that you love and that feeling when you're around the people that you love, when that little spark, you know, that you have. I'm sure you guys feel it when you get together
and
see a podcast.
The old dingo puts a smile on my face. My wife, you know, my lovely wife said, if I drop off the purse, you're going to marry that strange bloke with all them shirts.
He only wants me for my shirts.
There you go.
Haley, as you said, Fireworks, that's your second cracking single from your forthcoming album, set for release in 2021. If these first two singles are any indication, it's going to be a must-buy album. So where did the you spoke briefly about Fireworks. So who'd you write that one with?
I wrote this one with my good mate Phil Barton and his partner Dana Heaton-Tabu. And, over Skype during lockdown. And, these two, I've known Phil for a very, very long time and he's never really had a partner. He's always I hope he's not listening to this. So it's been a bit of a wandering soul. And, I saw them, those two together, and I thought, oh, this is gorgeous, that young love, you know. And so we wrote the song about, you know, that beautiful feeling when you're in love and the spark that you get when you're with people and, you know, or it could be your pet. Anyway, so the music video we've just done for it is really, really cool. It's just about to come out. I asked a whole lot of my Haley's Comets to film themselves with sparklers, with, you know, the one they love or their kids or their pets. So we've got, you know, all sorts of shenanigans going on in the video, but it's lovely just being able to have, you know, feature all these beautiful people that have supported me through this wretched time.
Did Dingo have a sparkler?
No.
Dingo.
What's going on, Dingo?
Where are you, mate?
Oh, my shirts are in the wash.
You can't say you're camera shy. No. You should see him here. He's got the makeup. We've got to employ the makeup lady and the hairdresser.
I had a hairdressing joke earlier on today.
You're just so high maintenance, Dingo. I don't know how I'll put up with you.
So, Haley, let's get serious for a moment. Hey, Fireworks showcases your strong vocal range with a punchy upbeat tune. How did you manage the recording process with, as you said, COVID restrictions in force?
Yeah, look, it's been a real... It actually hasn't really been a challenge. It's been an adventure. It's been a really fun time. Learning production skills and, I've recorded my vocals at home in my cupboard. Literally, I never thought I would do that, but I did. And I've worked out, you know, Logic Pro and I learned how to at least track my vocals and send them off to the producer in Canada. And then he sort of pulled all the music together over there. And we just kind of worked collaboratively, sending sounds back and forth and, you know, ideas so that's sort of how we did it with Breaking Hearts and Fireworks. So I guess the trend's going to continue because it doesn't look like I'm going to be over in Canada anytime soon, but, it's actually been great to just, you know, stand in my house. I can be in my pajamas, whatever. And, you know, sing, sing for as many takes or a few takes or however long I want, you know, have a cup of tea in the middle, and not be worried about the pressure of being in a studio where your time's constrained and, you know, so it's been great to just sort of explore that. And yeah, I think it's been good to take that pressure off and just, yeah, see what we can do. So.
I was just going to say, so do you have understanding neighbours or a very soundproof cupboard?
Soundproof cupboard. I've got the foam up on the, you know, on either side. You open the doors of the cupboard and there's foam on either sides and all that sort of thing. So, no, the neighbours are great, actually. I do my little balcony concerts, have been doing them through COVID and stuff, and, yeah, they have been good. We haven't had that many complaints, so...
Well, that's great. A good sign, yeah.
That's a good sign. So Fireworks is, once again, one of your great songs. It's performing very well and getting lots of airplay and love on streaming services. You've got to be happy with that again.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's only, you know, only been out a few weeks, couple of weeks, really. Actually, it came out last week. There we go. So, yeah, and so far it's been doing great. It's just called today that it's been added to, you know, Aussie Country on Apple Music or what have you, and lots of radio stations and you guys, you know, playing it and getting behind it. So I'm, you know, couldn't be happier. It's a great way to sort of end the year with a bit of bang, some fireworks.
Well,
very well said. Very well said.
Well, speaking of fireworks, you touched briefly on your video with your Hayley's comments, but what I noticed was your fireworks TikTok challenge. Now, I saw Abby Ferris, who featured in episode 8. She absolutely nailed it the other day. Now, I'm not a TikTok person, so how do people participate in your fireworks TikTok challenge?
Oh, look, this is just a little bit of fun, and it's taken off, so it's great. I've got people all around the world doing their little fireworks videos. Now, Abby did it absolutely perfectly, and some people are like, oh, no, it's too hard. You can just improvise, you know? So what I want people to do is, so if you've got TikTok, go in there, you can select fireworks as the audio, and just do your fireworks dance to it. There's a few examples of different people doing it up there already. But, you know, you just do your own. Improvise. And, yeah, just hashtag fireworks challenge, tag me, and I'll reshare it. I'm loving seeing all the videos come in. And, yeah, just a little bit of extra fun, you know.
All right, Dingo, that's your challenge for the week.
Off you go, you too. The big arm. Bye. You know.
I've got some sparklers. Knowing my luck, I'll set off the smoke alarm or the fire detector or something.
I'll take you down to Canberra, mate. We'll just get a big bag of fireworks. And
big
we'll,
bag of fireworks.
We'll there
go
down, you go.
We'll go down the park and we'll have our own little...
Oh. Yeah, do that.
Hayley.
Sparklers are fine too. Do your own improvising with your spark. You can be part of, you know, an unofficial part of the music video.
Yeah. So with both singles, Breaking Hearts and Fireworks, both at radio and available for purchase and streaming, are you taking a break over Christmas or continuing to work on your forthcoming album?
I'm taking a little bit of a break, but I'm really going to just keep the pedal to the metal. These things take, you know, music takes time to produce, and especially when you're doing it the way that we're doing it, you know, long distance production, that sort of stuff. It's kind of you know, you want to just keep the momentum going because there's long lead times on all these things as well. So I'll be, you know, I've got the next songs ready to roll and I'm excited to be performing a few of them in my upcoming shows that I'm doing, fireworks tour, giving people a bit of a sneak preview of the songs as well. And yeah, so just got to keep the momentum going, you know?
Do you have an anticipated release date yet, or you're just going to have more singles up your sleeve for a little while?
There'll be a few more singles to come before the album drops, but I'm thinking, you know, around July would be a good time, I think. So yeah, we'll see what's sort of happening. But yeah, around the middle of the year, I think we're planning to put it out. So yeah,
We could all meet interstate and have an old-time cracker night fireworks launch.
Yeah. Wow.
Just need someone with a property. You don't need to go in the state.
Oh, you do need to get the crackers from somewhere.
From Canberra. Yeah. Well, I'm actually headed down there. This
You've got a couple of gigs, dude.
I do head down there this this Sunday. Actually, it's my show down in. So I'll pick a few up for you if you want. Okay.
They are strange people. I mean, there's some strange shops down in Canberra.
I was going to say, don't say that. I'm from Canberra. Yeah. Or actually, maybe it's true. But yes, there are, especially in the places where you can buy fireworks.
I say, you got to learn how to stay warm if you come from Canberra. Jeez, it gets cold down there.
It does. It gets very hot and very cold.
Yes.
It does, yeah.
Oh, Hayley, yeah. Can you remind our audience how they can find out more information on you, follow your career, buy some of your merch, stream your live shows, or the new one, keep tabs on your fireworks TikTok challenge?
Yes, absolutely. Look, you put my name in the old Google and everything will come up, but HayleyJensen.net is my website, and then Hayley Jensen on all the Facebooks and Instagrams and TikTok, obviously, now. So, yeah. Stay in touch and getting a whole lot more live shows happening in 2021 as well. So, yeah, really looking forward to just getting back out there and performing these songs live as well.
We've been talking to Hayley Jensen about her latest single, Fireworks. Hayley, thanks for chatting with Australian Radio Indie, and we're looking forward to more great music from you with the release of your album in mid-2021. All the best for the holiday season. I hope Santa is good for you. Speaking of Santa... Speaking of Santa, if people listen to the end of the program, they might get a great surprise from Hayley. We won't tell people what it is at the moment, but hang around after fireworks for a very special surprise. Hayley, you know what we're talking about. What about I get you to introduce your latest single?
Do I know what's going on here?
No, you don't. Hayley, I'll get you to introduce your latest single.
You don't even know about it, James. No. He always comes. He pulls something out of his back pocket every week, this little thing.
No, we've been colluding on something in the background.
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Absolutely.
So I'll get you to introduce your latest single, Fireworks.
Absolutely. This is Hayley Jensen with my brand new single. This is Hayley Jensen with my brand new single, Fireworks, on Australian Radio Indie.
And here it is.
I get that beat, beat, beating in my heart, and that's just where it starts. I get that boom, boom, thinking about your kiss, and nothing can compare to this. I get a butterfly feeling, it's like I'm shooting through the ceiling. It's like fireworks, baby, when I'm with you. There's just something about your touch, but nothing beats that rush. It's a hallelujah love, and it's flying right off of the charts. It's like fireworks, baby, when I'm with you. It's just so electric, a sweet high that you'll never forget. It's like fireworks, baby, when I'm with you. We're like dynamite, burning around to the fuse. We're shining bright, we're up all night. You'll light me up, and it feels so bright, like fireworks, baby, when I'm with you.
Yeah, there's Sonic and Ashton going off again.
I think we'll replace one of your earworms with the fireworks earworm, Jonesy.
The fireworks earworm. I don't know. It's just got that nice. I don't know what it is. It's a rhythmic sort of a song. It just plays along. It's not like it hasn't got that, you know, that awful worm that sticks in your head.
It's just got the good vocals.
It's a lovely song. Lovely song.
Now, let's see.
Thanks, guys.
Hayley, thanks for staying on the line while we played your new song, Fireworks. Now, you and I have a very, very special surprise. Maybe a broadcast exclusive.
Really?
I think it is a broadcast exclusive. Yep. Jonesy. Right here, right now.
So, last episode, Jonesy, I put out a call for artists, and I think I used the terms, I'm looking for a ripper Christmas track, and I asked people to send it in. Now, I went and did a little bit of research, but I knew Hayley was scheduled in for this week, so I thought, well, you know what? Here's a dumb question. Hayley, have you got a Christmas song? So, I might hand it over to Hayley. So, Hayley, tell us about your Christmas song.
Yeah. So this song's never really been released under my name, but I record, it was a producer that I worked with when I was over in Nashville doing my Turning Up the Dial album. And he contacted me after the fact and said, Hayley, you sing session vocals. I've got this Christmas song. We're putting on this massive concert in Nashville. You know, and my client wants to record some songs and needs a great vocalist. And, you know, and I was like, oh, well, thank you very much. All right. So he ended up sending through the track, and yeah, I recorded the vocals here and sent them over, and it's a great catchy song. Reba McEntire's done it and a few others, and I hadn't really heard it before, but it is a really great Christmas song, and it's just done in the best arrangement. I love it. So this is my little take on Up on the Housetop.
That is. Don't be, yeah, come on. Tell us who your producer was for this song.
Jamie Tate, yeah, Grammy Award winning producer in Nashville.
Wow. Yeah, Jamie Tate. I'm just looking for someone to sing a song. Oh, Jamie. Yeah. Hayley, could you sing a song for me?
Yeah, no, he's been great like that, actually. So he's a great producer, and, you know, I thought surely there's plenty of singers in Nashville that you could just whip in and that would lay down the vocal, but no, okay, sure. Wow. I'll record it over the other side of the world for you, so. Yeah,
wow,
I had
fantastic.
A lot of fun doing it.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's funny how you talk to people like, Travis New? I was talking to him the other night up at the MySex gig, and he just said, man, when Nashville's on fire, this was like before the COVID crisis, but he said, when Nashville's just on fire, you've got a whole town of quality players, and it's just, they're just coming out of the woodwork, and the ones that we don't know about yet are still just moving into town. So it's a real hard, like a cutthroat industry, the music scene. But he was just saying, like, if you're a guitarist, a bass player, a drummer, you've got to be the best of the best to be noticed in Nashville.
You have to.
Yeah, so congratulations.
Yeah. Oh, well, thank you. I thought it was a huge compliment as well. I thought, gosh, surely you can just walk out into the street and go, any singers around? No, it was lovely working with them.
So do you like the surprise, Jonesy?
Yeah.
I think this is sensational.
I thought you might use that term, sensational. Hayley, we might say good luck. Bye for now. Peace and love, and thanks for the extra time. As I said, hope Santa is very, very good to you. Hayley, I'll get you to introduce your Christmas song.
This is going on the playlist. This is going to hit the station.
Yeah. So.
Woohoo! Love it. This is Hayley Jensen with my Christmas song, Up on the Housetop on Australian Radio Indy.
Up on the housetop, reindeer paws. Out jumps good old Santa Claus. Down through the chimney with lots of toys. All for the little ones' Christmas joys. Ho, 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 who wouldn't go? Ho, ho, ho. Up on the housetop, click, click, click. Down through the chimney with old Senor. First comes the stocking, the little Nell. Under Santa, feel it well.
Australian Radio Indie.
Jonesy, an Australian Radio Indie worldwide exclusive, don't he?
Well, you know, I should say, that's very good work, young dingo.
Sensational. I didn't even get it that sensational.
Sensational.
Anyway, sometimes you just ask dumb questions and you get wonderful responses.
A good friend of mine said a dumb question is a question never asked.
Oh, okay.
That's on a T-shirt. A dumb question is the question never asked.
Okay. Well, all I said to Haley when I knew we were preparing for that, when we were preparing, Haley, do you have a Christmas song? And she said, somewhere. She'll have to go into her archives. And So there is a song that was
recorded. She does a lot of work in Canada, doesn't she?
Canada and the US. Yeah. So, yep. So, you know, award-winning producer.
Oh, yeah.
Award-winning producer asks her to record a song, and it's, I'm thinking next year, perhaps a Christmas album from Haley. Just putting it out there.
Yeah, we should.
I think her fans would love it. Anyway, so, yes, very, very good song there by Haley.
Thank you,
Haley, for letting us play that song for you. So I decided on the basis of that to get into the Christmas spirit.
Yeah.
And that's not the Drambuie or the Creme de Menthe.
Well, God, you're coming out with the big words there, mate. All I know is the red and the white and maybe a 4X gold.
That's my limit. Okay. Well, so I and you know how I like to do shirts or at least have some sort of theme thing happening.
Really? You're asking me that question. Do I know you like to look at something with shirts? Well,
so and
I mean, we've had this one before, I'm sure.
We have had this one before, but I figure the red and the green and the little chilies look like little Christmas decorations.
As they say in the classics, red and green should never be seen together.
Except
at Christmas.
No, hang on. Red and green, or is that Cardinal and Myrtle for South Sydney?
I wouldn't even know who they are.
No, they're the official colours of South Sydney.
Oh, for those two people.
Yeah, well.
Cardinal red?
No, yeah.
Oh, I thought you said cardinal. I thought that must be a player.
No, red and green. I mean, people just go red and green, but cardinal and myrtle are the...
Myrtle? What the hell's myrtle?
We'll cover it. Less rambling. Anyway,
green.
So I thought...
Green's myrtle.
Yep, so I thought I would wear that myrtle because that does look like... I mean, that one there,
yeah.
They do look like a bit of Christmas decorations.
Well, that looks really red
look like
that.
Christmas decorations.
They do, actually. You go back and from there and you're red and green, you look like a South Sydney supporter.
And?
He's ho ho hoing people.
I got the ho ho ho, and I know that we spoke about. And I sometimes don't put you into the pre-production meetings, but here we go.
Jesus, what's going on?
Here we go.
Oh my God!
We've got the special. I don't have many Christmas t-shirts. There we go, Jonesy.
Okay, so we're going with three stages of. Of a man's life, we've got, believes in Santa?
So, three stages of a man's life. Believes in Santa.
Yep.
Doesn't believe in Santa. And looks like Santa.
Oh, man. I think you nailed it there, my friend. Oh, man, he goes over and above, I tell you. And he goes, all the girls, look, please do not request for Dingo to take his shirts off ever again. If anyone requests that, you will be...
Anyway, I just thought I'd dig out the Christmas. As I said, I don't have too many Christmas shirts, but I thought with that worldwide exclusive. Sorry, Haley, if that's taken the edge off your supper.
I've got red, orange, and black.
Anyway, thank you for sharing a part of your week with us. Trust you enjoy the music. Check out Haley Jensen online. Give Fireworks and her other music some love and attention.
Fantastic artist. Fantastic.
We've had Summertime Soundtrack. Breaking Hearts, Fireworks, and her surprise Christmas song, Up on the Roof. Follow her on social media. Stream her songs. Let her know you heard them on Australian Radio Indie. We'll be back next week with a fresh playlist. Like and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Leave a comment.
Certainly. Join the thousands of people, or the 184 that have subscribed.
They're going up.
Yeah, and the listeners, I tell you what, the listeners on WHER for our show at 6 p.m., Dingo gets a run every Friday, and I'm there Monday to Thursday because I'm special. Their listenership has absolutely skyrocketed due to their change of format. They've changed their playlists and changed their music.
To incorporate some more Australian great Australian great music, not just country music.
No, that's it. We've decided to collaborate with the guys at WHER, so we're doing a bit of their artists. They've only sent a few over, but lovely artists as well. Some good country rock artists are coming through, and they're they're smashing us out. They want this week they're chasing Christmas music. I think I'm going to hold that one back.
I've got a few Australian Christmas artists. We can share.
Well, they're doing a Christmas spectacular, and it's coming out on Christmas Day, and their spectacular is going to be a video. And I'll tell you what, if you haven't seen last year's Christmas special on their YouTube channel, man, they do a great job. They're from the theatre, so they're theatre-based.
Okay.
Their background's in theatre, so they put the bells and whistles on, and they get all their cast and crews in. And, they do a great job. So they're doing a new Christmas show on WHER, which is What's Happening Entertainment Radio. And, he asked me, he was definitely keen on Craig Stewart's Santa Swapped His Sleigh for a Surfboard. He said, man, I've never seen that one. That's a cracker. Because
I requested that when I was in Paris one day, and you were at the other radio station, and I called in and said, Jonesy, and you said, well, what's it like outside? And I said, it's snowing. And you said, well,
Here's a Christmas song.
Anyway, so where do we get up to?
We'll have to have a chat with Craig Stewart one day. He's a fantastic Australian country singer, and he's got some great stories with hanging out with Drew McAllister and all the boys at the Country Music Academy and stuff.
I know that we've got someone extra special next week, and then we'll have Christmas, so perhaps in January we can get him on.
Yeah, we might do some film clips for him. That'll have to be February.
Mm-hmm.
Because my time's really busy in January.
Yeah, it is.
I'm very much taken aback.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, yeah.
Okay, so where'd we get up? We should be supporting. You should be supporting Australian Radio Indie TV, and as we've spoken about there, Tony and Tim at WHER. And as we say now, here's your homework. Listen or stream some new music. If it's safe where you live, go out and see some live music while you're there. Buy some merch or buy one of their buy some of their music, and if you can't do that because of COVID lockdowns, consider donating to Support Act or the virtual tip jar of your favorite artist. Finally, if you're an artist out there, we've still probably got a couple of spots for a few Christmas songs, and that will be just before Christmas, so that might just end up being an audio. We'll see what happens.
Even if you want to sing a Christmas song recorded well with a nice next to your Christmas tree or a not burning fireplace, or next to something Christmassy, record
Phil Jonesy's inbox.
Yeah, so send them away. I've been told this week I'm going to get swamped with requests, so you get your requests in, and that helps the top 10. So let's see.
Anyway,
what happens.
Until the next time, be kind to each other. Stay safe. Have a wonderful week. Listen to some music. See you next time, Jonesy.
Are we going out with a song?
Peace and love.
Peace and love. Peace and love to all our favorite fans and listeners.
And bye for now. And as for a song, well, I know that when we were discussing with Hayley, I put a couple of songs forward to her.
Yeah. I had you upside down, sorry.
Okay. That is, I know when I was discussing with Hayley our playlist for today, I suggested a couple of songs, and she came back and said, can we play these songs? And I said, sure, why not? But Jonesy, I know that one of her favorites, one of your favorite songs of hers is...
Yeah, the one that was 3 weeks at number one.
Turning up the dial.
On the ARI Top 10 Hot Hits.
So I think we should get that song happening. Jonesy, make it so. Hayley Jensen.
Great song.
Turning up the dial.
And here it is. Next week.
Bye.